What up, Daquan? No, what? No, I'm just I woke up like about a roughly around an hour ago. Or not like an hour ago, no, roughly an hour. I'm not sure when, but I woke up. Mom told me what I wanted to eat. I told her. I'm not sure. I hopped on the computer and saw that everybody was on Discord and they were watching a movie. So I joined their movie. They're watching Interstellar. I don't know if you've ever seen it. Oh no, the movie ended a while ago. The what? Nice. I'm proud of you, man. Arif was on. But he's not here anymore. The what? I'm gonna play a little bit more of this game. I get that bread. I haven't listened to the playlist yet. Sounds good. Other what?
a chance against Typhon. Who's with me? No.
No! You will all die, for your stupidity! Wow!
sight of the Great Hall took Phoenix's breath away.
This is incredible!
It's all right. Could use some updating. The column motif is a bit played out.
So, we're safe here.
Remember that thing I stole from Typhon? It was an itty-bitty piece of his eye, to hide this place from his terrifying gaze. You're welcome.
You said this is the Hall of the Gods. Well, where are the others?
Let me start from the beginning.
With his hand on Phoenix's shoulder, Hermes recounted the tale of Typhon, destroyer of gods. Typhon, born of Gaia, was a terrible, cruel beast who vowed to free the Titans and obliterate the gods. He challenged Zeus for the rule of the cosmos. Fortunately, Typhon was defeated.
Damn straight he was!
And imprisoned under a mountain, where he could do no more harm.
I got to get back into that kind of shape again.
For thousands of years, Typhon festered, until Helios was eclipsed, and burning stars fell from the heavens. The stars burnt through Typhon's chains, and in an explosion of fire and smoke, Typhon burst from the mountain. The gods had wronged and tortured him.
Never again!
He vowed.
This world will be cleansed. The gods will pay!
And so, Typhon sought his revenge.
Destroy the veil that separates this hallowed land from the underworld. Let Tartarus walk among the gods! Trample, devour, and turn these life-false gods to dust! Come, Olympians! Brandish your weapons and face me! You have underestimated my power and wag in your hubris! Bow to my unseekable perfection!
Some gods fled in fear. Others stayed to fight. Many were captured. Typhon split them apart, cleaving their essences from them, and transforming them irrevocably. In a final, desperate attempt to save their lands, the gods called on the heroes of old, the last warriors who had more than a few drops of God's blood remaining in their veins.
Weak and selfish! Your heroes will exist as shadows of their former selves, serving me forever!
The gods had failed, and so had the heroes. But just when all hope seemed lost,
so yeah, a lot of fighting and losing. And now you are our only remaining hope to restore these lands to their former glory and save the world from chaos. All we have, Phoenix, is you. No pressure.
I kind of lost track of who's who. Is that one with the spiky hair you or Typhon?
Forget it. The vanquished gods need to be reunited with their severed essences to regain their power. And then, together, you must defeat Typhon.
This is honestly a lot. I wish my brother was here.
Look, kid, I'm not perfect. I'm the guy who escorted Pandora to Earth for Zeus's sake. But maybe, just maybe, you're the right hero at the right time. Also, you're literally all we've got, seeing as how everyone else has been defeated. Good luck! I'll be right here, doing nothing. I mean, beginning preparations.
Thanks! I think.
Oh, there's that face again. Fine. Your best starting point is to reach the top of the other statues on the Golden Isle, so you can track the missing gods. Find them, and they should be able to help you locate their stolen essences. Although, they haven't been themselves, so I'm really not sure.
What's that mean?
Guess you'll find out.
Phoenix, think. What would my brother do? Oh! Is this Hephaestus's forge?
You're cute. Try not to impale yourself on anything.
But Phoenix wasn't listening. She was drawn to the forge by a hidden force. The Aramantine she'd gathered, calling out to be reshaped.
Yeah, whatever. You did the lead challenge? Hey, nice. How much you get?
Nice cauldron!
Phoenix let the empty compliment die in the ensuing silence, and instead tried to focus on potential potion recipes.
Numbers are hard. Hey, that's good, bro. Yeah, for shizzle, dog. Hey, what you mean, bro? Yeah, for shizzle, dog. See, that's what you my nigga, bro. You keep an 92 plus 8.
Mortals seem to need an incentive. So, I'll pay you Electrum for accomplishing each. And since I'm the god of merchandise,
huh?
You can spend it right here on,
huh?
You guessed it, merchandise.
No.
Ooh, creative.
Or you could always just pay me your own Electrum.
I thought
on
the
what?
Incentive was for me.
I'm the
Facebook?
God of financial gain.
Those prices. Wow.
I'm also the god of thieves.
Oh, for a moment there you said bitch.
What's that underneath?
Thank
it's
you.
A chore chart. Someone has to get Ares to clean up after himself. Ever tried to get blood out of a sea of blood? Now that is a feat.
Why? I'm still sick.
If you're in the market for anything.
You're different. Oh, you mean where you're fingering a woman?
Dental exams?
No, it's where we rip off our skin to change our appearance.
What do you mean? You use this a lot.
Huh. Still better than visiting the dentist.
When you finger a woman, it's like playing violin. I'm also in the Discord. Oh, we're watching Anthony play Guitar Hero. Still looks like Guitar Hero. Oh, I haven't.
What's this?
Not sure. Hades had it delivered. Deposit an offering for the ferryman, and unexpected help could very well arrive. Be careful, though. Argo broke the last gift from the underworld, and look what happened to him.
Who's Argo?
Exactly.
I want to upgrade my skills, bro. Ooh. Yo, that looks sick. It's pretty cool. Burning a hole in your pocket?
Ah, there's that wonderful smell again.
Ambrosia is life. You want increased protection? Distill it here and drink up. Then enjoy the ride. One time, Athena downed that whole Kelix and destroyed the entire Greek fleet right after she had sided with them in battle. It was epic. Sorry. Guess you just had to be there.
Many of my relatives were. They died.
And I told Athena not to do that. But did she listen? No.
You can upgrade your health that many times, bro. Yo, I'm making salsa, bro. I'm sorry to tell you, Haiti, but it doesn't have a city, bro. We're going down. Gotta keep bullet. I need rocks. Keggy. Where did my rock go? He ain't missing a single shot, bro. Uh-huh. How'd you get in there? Yes, the power is mine. Blah 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 blah. Let's see. With finisher combos. Eat that man's ass. What's wrong with that? Look, guys, it's Paddington. Yo, I'm digging this song. Oh, Tony's playing some rock song. Hey guys, Daquan said hi. They said, why being a bitch and not joining Discord? He said, quit being a slut and join. You're not slurring here. Whatever song's playing right now that you're playing, Anthony, is for some reason I feel motivated.
Phoenix stumbled upon a winged as Phoenix freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle. She let out a cry, which meant, great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory.
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Phoenix would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing?
Okay. Oh, that's a liar. Yeah. Yeah. It's Mexican what? Mm-hmm. Bruh. I feel like that dating website's where they're gonna sex traffic kids, bruh. Come on. Yeah, sounds good. Yeah. Just put, I'm American, that's all you need. He's camping, bro. He's missing all of these. This is a YouTube video. Yes. Peace out, Tommy Gillian. How long have you been drinking cilantro? Oh, nice. Shaking my head. Bitches do be tripping. Middle. Left, middle, left, right. How do I encompass this whole map? Middle, left, middle, left, right. Everyone never went to the end of her hand.
Tell me the deeds of golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song, stir up my sweetest passion.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
I believe in you, bro. I guess it's the other ones. You have a very defined palette. Nah, you picky as fuck. You picky as fuck, bro. It's because you're a fruity ass guy. You're gay, that's gay. Hey, what's my last name? Shit. Shit. Yeah, got me. Avocado. No, we don't. Ooh. We don't. It's a ray below. Yeah. Sound like that. I'll ray below. Avocado. They called you. They call you Green Nick. Hey, close the door, Green Nick.
Ah, the Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. Hall of the Gods. Eros's palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the goddess of beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Phoenix's eye.
Phoenix was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
sure to tell all your fellow creatures that I am here to serve them. Fresh up!
Suddenly,
you wouldn't happen to be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Phoenix, sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
Oh, that's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. Oh, if only I could travel to those most in need. But, alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault, wedged under my largest root, which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer, so I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course, my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh. Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty sea foam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure sea foam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl? Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Phoenix. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Why are you whispering?
Because I don't want to scare it away.
What are you on? Because can I have some? Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard. Aphrodite, sweet and charitable. No more mischief.
Isn't that what you were aiming for when you married her off to Hephaestus against her will?
Hey now, it wasn't. I mean, she knew I was doing it for her own good.